People are saying that this year's talent is the best yet. And the best part, you are taking charge. Tonight, the guys hit the stage for the first time as we build our top 12. This is American Idol. The auditions are over. We have made it back into the studio. Now, it's not just a stage. This is a platform that will launch someone into superstardom. I hope you're ready for the challenge because the judges are relinquishing control and handing things over to you. Your first task is to get us down from the remaining 24 people to our top 12. There are six places in there for the guys, and here they are. David Hernandez. Chiquizzi, David Cook, Jason Yeager, Robbie Carrico, David Archuleta, Danny Noriega, Luke Menard, Colton Berry, Garrett Haley, Jason Castro, and Michael Johns. Ready to go, gentlemen? Let's have a good one. And the girls are watching from the sidelines. Hello, ladies. Give it up for them. It's their turn tomorrow night. Over the next 3 weeks, both groups are going to take the stage separately. On the strength of your votes, we lose the bottom two girls and the bottom two guys each week until we're left with six guys and six girls making up your top 12. And our judges are here to see what you did with their selections. Give it up for Randy Jackson.
What up, baby? What up? Yeah.
Paula Abdul. And loving this moment, Simon Cowell. So, Randy, let me start with you. When you think about this group and we say best talent ever, what stands out about this group in your mind?
You know what, man? This audition season for me, Ryan, man, I saw more originality in these dudes up here, man. So, you know, hopefully they're going to show us a little bit of that tonight. Keep it real, boys. Come on now.
And Paula, as we start to vote now, what should America really hone in on and look for?
First and foremost, to just give it up to Randy. He only said two dogs and three mans.
Exactly, yo. Exactly.
It's very what? Shocking. It's
wait till tomorrow night when he calls the girls men.
Exactly.
Man, you were great, girl.
No, I think everyone has to pick the right songs and have a blast. And Simon's just trying to say something in my
he
ear.
He wants to say something so bad.
I know you're nervous to speak to the public, as you often are.
Yeah, he's back in America, Ryan.
What would you like to say to motivate this group of young people who are here trying
yes.
to reach and achieve their dreams?
Yes.
Ryan, we are 30 seconds yes. from doing the show. It's a bit late.
Come on, Simon, please.
Look,
words
of wisdom. It's down to them now. I'm looking for personality, originality, and obviously you've got to sing well.
Okay.
Right?
Thank you for that. That was original. I will say the judges did an excellent job finding these guys that you'll be voting for tonight. You did. Before we head into a quick break, we're going to remind you just how it all went down. We'll see you in a few minutes.
I was really impressed.
You have a pretty amazing voice.
100,000,000% yes, dude. Hey, you got a gift, Danny.
Jason, you're going to Hollywood.
Welcome to Hollywood. It's a yes for me. Joe Dahl.
Hollywood!
See you guys in California. Come on, Mom.
That's the biggest high I've ever had, ever.
I think you're coming on really strong. It's a yes.
No, work is paying off.
I am feeling groovy.
It was incredible.
You're the real deal.
Oh. Well done, Colton.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
One of the best vocals today.
Oh.
You made it, baby.
Are you serious?
You made it.
You made it.
You made it, Danny.
Yay!
This is the land of dreams, and I'm trying to make mine happen.
It's my life. It's everything.
This is the moment of my life, the time where all my dreams could come true.
Welcome back to the show. Before the guys get out here, a quick side note. American Idol's teamed up with iTunes. You can keep a piece of the show by heading to iTunes throughout the season and downloading performances by your favorite contestants. Now, back to the competition. Tonight's songs are all from the 60s. Kicking it off, here's David Hernandez.
Ain't you quite the big? Oh, no, no. Please don't leave me, girl. Ain't too proud to bleed, baby, baby, please don't.
I'm 24 years old. I'm from Glendale, Arizona. When I sing, it comes from my soul. You know, I've been through a lot in my life. I was raised by a single mom, you know, low-income housing for a while, pretty broken family. So when I sing, it's an escape for me.
And there's a rose in a twisted flower, and the
Final Judgment Day, I was a wreck. I was crying, and I walked up the elevator, and I felt really emotional. So Randy was like, the decision wasn't unanimous, and I was like, oh, okay.
David, I wasn't the one who said yes, by the way, and I think you're gonna have to work a heck of a lot harder for you to have even a remote chance of winning.
You know, most people might have been discouraged with him saying that, but I actually felt challenged. My plan now is to prove Simon wrong. You know, I'll be damned if someone's gonna tell me that I don't have a shot.
I'm going away till the midnight hour. That's when my love starts tumbling down. I'm going away till the midnight hour. When there's no one else around, I'm gonna take you, girl, and hold you, and do all the things I told you in the midnight hour.
Midnight hour.
Just see you and I. Stars come out and see that sweet love in your eyes. I'm gonna wait till the midnight hour. That's when my love begins to shine. You're the only girl I know, and I really love you so. In the midnight hour,
midnight hour.
In the midnight hour,
midnight hour.
Just see you and I,
just you and I,
in the midnight hour, midnight hour.
Yo, yo, all right, so this is cool, man. I like that you started with a little whole kind of gospel vibe in the front. Because I was like, yo, man, I remember this guy from the auditions. He could definitely blow, and you definitely proved it in the front of that. I mean, I thought you did a really good job. Fell a little apart at the end, and the only thing I'll tell you is just watch the long phrasing, because, you know, you got all the short kind of CV kind of stuff. Just have some long notes. But, baby, a way to start it off, man. Yo, the competition's on, baby. It's on. It's on.
It's always unnerving when the first contestant comes out, because, yes. you know, I feel for you. But you've got brilliant vocals to rely on, and what you do with them, how you color them up and go into your false, it's lovely. You got like perfect vibrato when you need it, and it's really cool. Really cool. Good job.
David, it actually was better than I thought it was going to be honest with you. I thought the beginning of the song was terrific. Middle part, it was all a little bit rabbit in the headlights. End, I didn't like. I think that you lost the note. I think you've got to loosen up a bit, to be honest with you. Very stiff, very nervous. My only criticism, once the song got going, is that I didn't hear anything distinct, particularly in your voice. But then again, I loved the beginning of it. So it was better than I thought it was going to be.
Well.
Great way to start off the night.
Yeah.
I sense a bit of relief from you. Would that be true?
Yes, I can just, you know, relax now. I feel a lot better. I'm glad I got it out of the first, you know, the first performance, so I'm happy. I'm excited.
And listening to what they have to say, does that help you with your self-confidence?
Absolutely. You know, Simon said stuff that I pretty much have been being told all day, you know, the confidence thing and loosen up a little bit. It's just being first.
So again, you didn't say anything original. is your point.
You said it, I didn't.
No, I'm just trying to make your point clear. If you want to vote for David, it's 1-866-IDOL-01. 1-866-436-5701. Or if you are with AT&T, you can text the word VOTE to 5701. Remember, these are 866 numbers, not 800 numbers. So please dial carefully. Phone lines open at the end of the show. Good luck, man. Thank you.
Thank you.
Next, the guy who shows the importance of sticking with your dream, Chakeezy.
I used to cry myself to sleep at night, but that was all before she came.
I'm 22 years old, I'm from Inglewood, California, and I'm a college student.
Chakeezy Ezzy's back for more.
Welcome to Hollywood, baby.
Last year, I got all the way to the end of Hollywood to be sent home.
Guys, it's the end of the road.
We only get better.
When I went home, I mean, I worked hard, and I came back more than ready.
That was good, dog. I ain't never heard you sound that good. That was good.
It couldn't have been better. It couldn't have been better. Finally, someone recognizes the work that I put in. You know, and it feels good when somebody recognizes your work.
You made it. You made it. You
Congrats,
made it.
Congrats, you made it, dog. Chakeezy, you're here, baby.
They saw the difference between last year and this year, and I guess that's what really told them that I was ready. So it was the best feeling ever.
I don't remember what day it was, and I didn't notice what time it was.
Chakeezy Easy is in the house. All right, so yo, man, it was pretty good, man. The only problem for me is that you're a little bit kind of an old-fashioned singer, right? So this kind of thing, being a 60s singer, this kind of being an old-fashioned thing, you got to always remember for you what's going to help you is to make it new, fresh, young, you know, what's going on. But you can definitely sing, man. You can definitely sing. It was all right. It was all right.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Chakeezy, nothing makes me happier than to see you here on the stage. Really, you've come a long way. And you're here. You are here. You look great. People may not know he's lost a lot of weight.
Yeah.
And you're.
I love singing.
I love Chakeezy singing. You're a throwback to great R&B.
Thank you.
And you're infectious. Your smile's infectious. I think you did a very nice job.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Simon Cole.
Here's my problem, Chakeezy. Chakeezy,
what? Sorry. Oh, don't go uh-oh.
Chakeezy, Chakeezy.
He got it. Only got it wrong once. Actually done it right every single time.
Okay, forgive me. But I absolutely hated the whole performance, and I'll tell you why. Let me finish.
The
suit is hideous.
No.
Let me finish.
White, gray, and black. Come on, dude. Who's your stylist?
I'm not the one who's singing.
Is Charlie Chaplin your stylist?
The suit is hideous.
Don't hit me because I'm willing to
The suit was hideous. The wink was hideous. The woo was hideous.
He winked at you?
Or someone. It was. I tell you why. Because
it was
all old-fashioned, corny, cheesy. And to be honest with you, this could have been something we filmed 40 years ago, 30 years ago. It was so old-fashioned.
You know what?
It wasn't.
By the way, do I ever interrupt you when you're talking?
It was 60s night, right? I was taking a 60s song of one genre and taking it to a different genre of the same era.
Okay.
That's what I was trying to do.
Sorry,
I'm sorry that you didn't understand that.
No, maybe you like the original.
Paul is sort of on your side. Simon giving you a hard time.
He does that. That's what he's for.
So what do you take away from all of that, then?
I understand that I need to bring some more things, basically do some more current music, which is difficult to do on 60s night.
No. You can make an old-fashioned.
But yeah,
song
he said that it's old-fashioned. I'm sorry.
It's
I just
coming from
was
a guy who
the
calls
music.
You Jacuzzi.
I was going to say, sorry for calling you a hot
take
time.
That.
Don't worry.
Right.
All right. If you want to vote for Jacuzzi, it's 1-866-IDOL02. 1-866-436-5702, or you can text the word VOTE to 5702. Standard text messaging rates apply. Good luck, man. Thank you very much. Appreciate the spirit. Wait a minute. Right here. We're taking a break. More hits coming up after the break. 60s Night returns with David Cook next. Now you can go. Welcome back to the show. Guys tonight, girls tomorrow, as we build the top 12. Sitting next to me, Colton Berry. And we haven't really had a chance to get to know you too much. So what would you like people to know about you, Colton, as they watch?
Only that from certain angles, I look like Ellen DeGeneres. Look.
I wouldn't have thought that, but okay. Which angles?
Left, right, and front.
Okay, good. Well, I wish you as much success as she has had. And the judges have given you a little bit of a hard time about being perhaps too theatrical. Have you tried to work on toning it down?
I've been trying, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I have a background in theater, so that's where I'm pulling from, I guess.
Well, good luck tonight.
Thank you.
We'll see your song in just a few. It's David Cook up next. You seem very, almost too comfortable.
Seriously?
Yeah, you're almost too relaxed.
Well, I'm glad I'm pulling something up.
Yeah. All right, you're up. Good luck, bro.
Oh, thank you, man.
Gina's dreams are running away.
I'm 25, from Blue Springs, Missouri, and I'm a bartender and musician.
Baby, it's okay.
I went into Omaha with absolutely no preconceived idea of how things were going to go.
Other than being a little bit worthy, it was good.
I still, to date, have no idea what Simon meant. By it was a bit worthy or wordy.
Worthy?
You know what I mean.
I'm gonna have to ask him about that. I have no idea what that means.
Three S's.
See you there.
Thank you, guys.
Hollywood was the first time in this whole process where I got legitimately nervous.
I think the minute you lose that guitar, you're gonna look very vulnerable up there. I'm gonna say no.
I'm glad he said no, because I think if he'd have said yes, I would have had way too much of a comfort level.
Stop me and steal my breath.
That was a terrific audition.
I got you this time, Simon. Thank you guys so much.
It was nice to have people outside of your circle say, hey, you know, you don't suck.
Imagine me and you, I do. I dream about you day and night. It's only right to dream about the girl you love and hold it tight. So happy together. If I should call you up and pass the time, and you say you belong to me and ease my mind, imagine how the world could be so very fine. So happy together. Toss the dice, it has to be. The only one for me is you, and you for me. So happy together.
right, so check it out, dog. Check it out. This is kind of funny for me because it started and I was like, dude, what song is this? Oh my God, no. Okay, so you started and it was a little weird for me, but dude, you know what? You worked it out and make a rock joint out of Happy Together. Dude, it was crazy.
Thank you so much.
I was like, if he can pull this off, he can do anything, Paula.
I couldn't agree more.
Dog, that was good,
I
man.
Have to tell you, it was a bit worthy.
It was a bit worthy.
It's worthy.
That was worthy.
It's worthy of great praise. You rocked it. You made something original. And if it was worthy, that's not your fault. It's the writer's fault.
So, Simon, worthy.
I can't remember if I said worthy or wordy. I genuinely can't remember, so I won't be able to answer that. I thought it was good. I thought you shouted the song a little bit in the middle, but it
needed that, though, for that rock edge.
It was a weird song to choose because I've never heard that song sung like that before.
I know, but that's why I liked it.
Almost made it believable.
Exactly.
I'll take it. It was believable.
Randy, you're seeing his persona evolve because you brought that up a while back.
Dude, I'm saying, you know, it started a little rough for me, but you got into it, and I love the whole kind of rock edge to a song like that. I mean, you know, I'm almost imagining that, you know, you're in Alice in Chains and you're singing that song. It's crazy. I love it.
Good news. All right, hey, congratulations again. David's number is 1-866-IDOL-03. It's 1-866-436-5703. Or if you're with AT&T Wireless, you can text the word VOTE to 5703. Thank you very much. Appreciate it. Good to see you. We're taking a break. When we come back, it is Jason Yeager. Hang on. Welcome back to American Idol. Remember, you're voting at the end of the show to keep your favorite guy in the running. The two with the lowest number of votes will be doing what, Randy?
Leaving us.
Bouncing.
That's right. Leaving us in the one-hour results show. That's coming up on a Thursday night, and that's when you don't really get to speak much, which is fun for the rest of us. Up next is Jason Yeager.
Well, I'm singing Mary. Tell Mother not to mourn.
I'm 28 years old from Grand Prairie, Texas, and I'm a singing server. I did audition in Dallas, and my son was with me, and he was totally blown away with the whole experience of being there, getting to see Ryan.
So your dad is a superstar. This one here?
Mm-hmm.
Is he the next idol?
Yes.
Welcome to Hollywood. It's a yes for me,
Joe
Dawg.
When I came out the door, my son, I picked him up and gave him a big hug, and it was a really, really awesome feeling. After watching the show for so long and wanting to do it for so long, I finally just gave it a shot, and I can't believe that I'm actually here.
You made it, baby.
Are you serious?
You made it.
Randy, are you serious?
You made it, baby. You made it.
Oh, my gosh. Yes.
My son, I would love to do this for him, to show him, you know, that you can achieve your dreams. Singing is everything I've ever wanted to do in my entire life. So, you know, this means everything to me.
Yo, check it out. I think you definitely did a pretty good job with that song. It's a tough song to sing, tougher than you probably even thought, right?
Yeah, absolutely.
Because it's like a simple song, great melody, made famous, you know, many years ago. But the thing is that I must say something, and I'm really impressed with all the boys I've seen thus far, because all you guys can definitely blow. You had a couple of problems, though, with that song, just pitch-wise. Make sure you never lose your concentration while you're singing a song like that, you know what I mean? Absolutely. Like, in the middle, I felt like you maybe went somewhere else a little bit in your head. Stay in it, man. Stay in it, baby.
I gotta say that that's very good advice, Randy. Because the simpler the song is, it's very difficult to sing, and staying on track is important. But I have such sentimental value to that song. I did my first ballet recital to it.
So.
So my
it's very sentimental to me too. That was dedicated to my grandmother. She taught me that song when I was very, very little, and I just, every time I hear that song, I always think of her. So she passed away when I was 16.
Simon, did you wear your first tutu to that song?
No, I bought my first puppy to that song. David, how old are you?
I'm 28.
28. Mm-hmm. Okay, you came over much older on that song. I'm going to be honest with you. I think it was very cruise ship, the whole performance. I do. And I think there are going to be a lot of young people watching this performance at home with a huge question mark over their head.
I think you're right on that, because I think the 60s is going to be... it's a little tougher to pitch.
Yeah, but you can cover 60s songs. The problem was that it was neither here nor there. You didn't go the kind of the Frank Sinatra route with it, which would have been great. It was just very, very middle of the road. You're like a dependable old dog, aren't you?
Like a sheep dog.
You know, you can rely on you, but it's not going to be very exciting.
How many dogs have you really raised from puppy?
We love dogs.
A lot.
Right. We love dogs.
Dependable dog.
Must love dogs.
About.
We got from the performance to Randy's speech on loving dogs. But now, as you listen to what they have to say, do you think that it makes a little bit of sense, though?
Yeah, I mean, I knew choosing that song, I was going to be running the, you know, the line of being too old-fashioned or, you know, cruise ship. I've been, you know, the vocal coaches have talked to me about trying not to come across as cabaret and stuff, so I tried to give it my best shot.
Now, you're an emotional guy, and I think people appreciate that. You're standing on this stage, and you hear Simon say something like that, which he said before to other contestants in the past. What does that really feel like in the gut?
You know, I try not to take it to heart too much. You know, that was actually the first time that Simon has actually had something critical to say, so I'll just try to take it as criticism and hopefully have a chance to come back next week and spice it up a little bit.
Well, I know Nathan's proud of you right there.
Yeah,
proud of you, partner. Too, good to see you. If you want to vote for Jason, 1-866-IDOL-04. It's 1-866-436-5704. Or AT&T wireless subscribers can text the word VOTE to 5704. Good luck, man. Thank you very much.
Thanks. Very much.
We are going to take a breather. We'll be right back with rocker Robbie Carrico and little David Archuleta. Welcome back. Remember, you're voting for your favorite guy out of the 12 we show you tonight. You can log on to AmericanIdol.com for all the latest on our top 24, including this guy, Robbie. How are you, sir?
Excellent. How are you?
Ready to do it? I'm well, thank you. Shall we hit the stage?
Yes.
Robbie Carrico. Good luck.
And don't forget that there is a someone up above, and be a simple kind of man.
I'm 26 years old from Melbourne, Florida. I've been doing this since I was 16 years old. I was in a boy-girl group back then. We toured with Britney Spears in 2000, then got back. I wanted to do rock so bad.
Welcome to Hollywood, baby. Come on now. Yeah.
Going into Hollywood Week, I was a little nervous. I got to do Hemorrhage by Fuel. I was really worried, how's this song gonna pull off with no guitar? The last minute, I almost changed it. And then I decided, you know what, it might be kind of cool with the piano.
Leave love bleeding in my hands again.
For me, you're the real deal. You're authentic.
Turned out really good. I was really surprised.
Oh, thank you very much.
Tonight, I want to show them me. Just put it all out on stage and just leave my soul right out there for the audience to see.
One is the loneliest number that you'll ever do.
Nice one, Robbie. Very nice one, man. I love that song. It's one of my favorite, like, Three Dog Night joints right there, man. And a nice version you did of it. You had me rocking out. I was like, yeah, I like this.
Thank you.
So, you moved me, baby.
Thank you.
Well, I think you picked the perfect song for you. You're authentic. You really are, and you stay true to who you are. You look fantastic tonight.
Thank you.
And you know what? The vocals weren't all over the top, but they were right in the pocket the way they should be.
I would say it's the only performance we've seen tonight which has any semblance of making sense. It's the only current performance. Oh, I mean, okay. It was.
You could hear it as a hit. You could hear it as
a hit. No, I thought it was a good performance. I'm struggling a little bit with what Paula said about the authenticity. You know, I'm not quite sure yet whether you're very comfortable in this rock thing. Is it really you, or are you a pop singer? That's what I'm trying. You tell me.
No, definitely not a pop singer. Right. I can sing anything, but I love rock, and I mean, this is me.
It's you.
Yeah.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. Why do you question the authenticity?
I don't know. It's just I question it because I'm not convinced yet, Ryan.
You buy it, Paula, Randy?
Since day one.
He's a rocker, definitely.
Dressed like a rocker, but kind of looks like Justin Timberlake, doesn't he?
What?
Hey, Justin can rock.
Yeah, Jeff, you can. If you want to vote for Robbie, it's 1-866-IDOL-05, 1-866-436-5705, or you can text the word vote to 5705. Good luck to you, man. Thank you very much. All right?
Appreciate
it. Thank you. Now, we're going to bring up David Archuleta.
We keep waiting. I'm 17, and I'm from Murray, Utah, and go to Murray High School.
Waiting
on the world. San Diego, it was really fun when Randy started singing along with me. It's like, oh, cool, I'm singing with Randy.
Distance, we keep waiting.
Waiting
on the world.
I was just so stoked for what was going to come next.
You keep me coming back for more.
Hollywood Week, I sang Heaven, and I love that song.
That was the bomb, the best I've heard yet since we've been here for days. You.
They said I was through to the top 24, and it was just like, oh, what a feeling, kind of thing. It's a huge opportunity being on this show, and you don't want to mess it up, so hopefully I do the right things, and you know, I'm getting shaky just thinking about it.
Shop around. Oh, you better shop around.
David Archuleta. Dude, how old are you, man?
17.
You know, look, man, I'm a big fan. I thought that was really brilliant. And you know what I love, dude, you're just born with this gift, because I'm saying, you sang that song so mature for somebody 17. I'm like, yo, man, this kid is ready to go. So, dude, I loved it. I loved it.
I feel it was a very brave and bold choice of song for you. We've never seen that side of you. And what's interesting is I forget all about how old you are. I just look at this unbelievably confident, older soul that just knows what's best for you. You really did a great job, David. You really did a great job.
When you got it, you got it. And yep. David, that was, by a comfortable mile, best performance of the night so far.
Wow, I wasn't expecting that, yeah.
What were you expecting?
I was just, you know, I don't know if it was like my best, so, you know, I'm really odd that that came out of them. Wow.
You're so likable. And you seem a little shy, you know, after the song, but during the song, as was pointed out, you're very confident. Do you feel extremely comfortable on stage during the song?
Well, you know, I love it, man, especially with the audience here. Wow. To help me get pumped.
Yeah. David Archuleta. No, go ahead and enjoy them.
Oh, no. They're done. Thanks.
Should we get out your numbers? You want to do that?
Oh, yeah.
Okay. All right, here we go.
Important, yeah.
If you want to vote for David, 1-866-IDOL-06.
How are you doing?
Six.
Good?
Oh, man.
Okay.
Doing great.
1-866-436-5706. Totally having fun. Enjoying yourself?
Yeah.
Or you can text the word vote to 5706. Standard text messaging rates apply. You can only vote for him. You actually can't adopt him, so... We're gonna take a break.
I'm 17. Just...
No, I know, but the ladies love you. Oh. And you love that they love you. We'll be right back in a few with some Elvis from Danny Noriega. Hang on. You're done. Welcome back to the show. Six guys down, that means six to go, and Danny Noriega is up next.
Left a good job in the city, working for myself every night and day.
I'm 18 years old, I'm from Azusa, California, and I'm currently unemployed.
You got a very good voice, Danny. Mm-hmm.
Thank you very much, yeah. Simon.
Last year, I got cut the first day in Hollywood on stage. It was pretty bad. It was pretty hard. I was like bawling for like the next week over. I thought I was gonna make it. The week after that, I was like, Mom, I think I want to audition again. I want to do this again. She's like, this kid's crazy. When I need you. Making it through the first day this year was definitely an accomplishment for me.
Best today by a mile. Three yeses.
Last year, I tried to create this little image that I thought the judges were looking for, and that was, I was going about it all wrong. I was not being myself. Tonight, when I perform my song, I want to bring my swagger and attitude on stage. I want it to be hot. So, I'm going to bring it.
Number 47 said the number 3. Got a cutest hell murder ever did see. I
Danny, what's going down, man?
Nothing much.
Just a little Idol season 7, yeah. You know. Dude, you know what I love about you? You know how to have a good time, man. You don't care what's going on, you're going to have a Danny's good time, right?
I'm going to bring the house down everywhere I go.
Bring the house down. Well, yeah, man, I actually thought it was pretty good. The vocals, I mean, I thought they were okay. It was an interesting song choice for me, for you.
Yeah.
It didn't allow you to do your thing. But, you know, you had a good time, so I love the performance out of you. That was cool, man. It was kind of hot.
Kind of hot. Okay.
It was very warm, almost scalding. You have really one of the most amazing vocals, especially when we saw you in San Diego. And I love hearing how your voice goes in and out of these beautiful colors. This was, in some ways, a safer song that allowed you to just be the performer, which is very important, too.
Sacred colors.
You know, I think that there's going to be a lot of colors of Danny coming out.
I don't understand a word of what you just said. Not a word. What color was that?
Purple.
Blue.
Yellow?
Blue.
Danny, I thought the performance was verging on grotesque.
Grotesque? How?
Because if you're going to take on Elvis, at least do it well. I mean, the whole performance was hideous. And I'll tell you why I say that, Danny. If this was the first time anyone tuned into this show by accident and saw that, which is somebody destroying an Elvis Presley song, they're not going to believe that this is the most talented group of kids in America. It was awful.
No, wait, the good thing
I'm sorry.
But I disagree.
And Danny, I don't care whether this one thinks you're yellow, orange, or purple, because all this colors nonsense is just ridiculous.
It's so funny, because I don't care what he says, either.
Well, Danny, you had a good time.
What I love about Danny Noriega is that he has a performer side to him. And you know what? People have seen your vocals. I mean, heard your vocals.
You hear vocals.
I got that one.
You hear them.
He's got mad vocal skills.
He's a first.
And you thought that was a good performance?
I said it was a safe performance.
Safe.
It didn't.
What was safe about it?
Help me out.
No, you can't answer the question.
You know what? No,
Here's the thing, Simon. The greatest
thing about the performance is you weren't trying to do Elvis. You were doing Danny.
Thank you.
Doing his own thing.
Ah.
So guess what? You shouldn't come out trying to be Elvis or sound like Elvis.
Like Elvis.
And you know what? Simon wishes he could wear that outfit and be hot in it.
I got the shoes.
What do you make of all of this back and forth between the judges? I see you nodding your head and agreeing with. I said grotesque, and I saw you nod yes.
Grotesque, it obviously means bad, but I didn't really,
It's the opposite of good. But you did say at one point when you saw him, he was the best of the day, and then the other end of the spectrum, grotesque. What do you think went wrong? What happened?
Yes, that's true.
That's so weird.
God, Ryan.
Song choice.
What do you think happened?
Song choice, I guess. I don't know. I kind of liked the song. I thought it'd be fun for a first show, but I don't know. Some people weren't liking it.
Yeah, Danny.
Careful, he might double snap you back. I have to tell you, it's very interesting, and I mean, with respect to all of you, it's very interesting to hear the difference of opinion from all of you, because a lot of different people watch, they all have different opinions. Kinda hot, colorful, grotesque. That's American Idol. Danny, the number is 1-866-IDOLS-07. 1-866-436-5707, or you can text the word VOTE to 5707. Calls are toll-free from landlines. Please don't vote until everybody's had a chance to perform. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Good to see you, and good luck. We are going to take a quick break. Luke Menard and Colton Berry next. Don't move. Welcome back to American Idol. The guys are fighting for the 6 available places in our top 12, and the girls are on tomorrow night. There they are. Ladies, you feeling good about tomorrow? Yeah? Okay. They're watching every move tonight to plan tomorrow. Will the idol be coming from the group down there, or will it be Luke Menard?
When you forget your name.
I'm 29 years old. I'm from Crawfordsville, Indiana,
and I'm a carpet cleaner.
Faces all
of my American Idol journey started actually season 6. I auditioned in Memphis, Tennessee.
How deep is your love? How deep is your love?
No.
Why?
Yeah, I say no too, man. I didn't think it was that good.
When I was cut in Memphis, it really drove me to come back and to work on things to be successful for this season. In Omaha, it turned out just how I hoped.
You made it through this time, Luke.
Yes.
Welcome to Hollywood, Luke.
Thanks, guys. When I came out of the room with a golden ticket, my wife was standing there, and she just jumped up and down and grabbed me and started jumping me up and down, and it was a great moment. This opportunity is, you know, it's a chance of a lifetime.
You made it.
Yay.
Congrats, Luke.
Woo! I didn't come here to make just the top 24. I didn't come here just to make the top 12. I came here to be the next American Idol, and that's what I'm here for.
Everybody's talking at me. I don't hear one word they're saying. Only the echoes of my mind. People stop and stare at. I can't see the faces. Only the shadows of their eyes. The sun keeps shining through the pouring rain. Going where the weather suits my clothes. Baking over the northeast wind, a sail on summer breeze, yeah. Skipping over the ocean like a stone.
What's up, man?
What's
Luke, man, you know, for me this time, dude, that song, it was very pitchy for me all the way through, you know, and I know that's like a word Paul and I use a lot, but it was like almost consistently sharp the whole way through the song, meaning that you sang the note higher than the actual note when it never settled for me. It wasn't great for me, dude. It was not great. Just try to keep it real.
I am going to agree in the sense that I don't feel that this was the best song choice for you, and I'm really grateful to have heard amazing auditions from you. When you sang Grace Kelly, when you sang your earlier auditions, you can tell your range is unbelievable. You have like Kenny Loggins
yeah.
You know, tenderness to your voice, and I hope that you'll be picking better songs.
What color was it?
Well, it wasn't black or gray, I know that.
Dark gray.
Luke, in a nutshell, whether you were pitchy or not, your problem was it was forgettable. No one is going to remember that as being either a great performance or a great vocal. You fell into the absolute worst trap you could fall into, yeah. Which is no one's going to remember you.
Oh.
It's true. Absolutely. It's absolutely true.
You know,
Luke Puller, shush. You have to stand out. You have to put your stamp on at this stage of the competition, and you didn't.
All right. Now, do you think that at this stage of the competition, you start to overthink each move? Because here we are in Hollywood on this stage.
Sure, it's very possible. Yeah. And there's some great competition here, and you gotta be right on.
We listened to what they said. How did you feel when you were singing the song?
I felt good. I didn't really feel like what they said was completely accurate. Thankfully, it's up to the voters now.
Right. What did you disagree with in terms of inaccuracy?
That it was forgettable. I don't agree with that. I think people are going to remember this tomorrow.
What do you think they'll see that's
stood out about that performance?
That I was just very comfortable and very content with the song, and I was just showing who I am, showing myself on TV.
No one's ever going to admit to being forgettable.
1-866-436-5708, or you can text the word VOTE to 5708. Don't vote until the end of the show. Good luck to you.
Thanks a lot.
Appreciate it. Thank you very much. Paula, you get the Patience Award tonight, having the patience, the most patience.
It's acquired.
Yes, acquired.
Coming up next, Colton Barry.
I used to think that I could not go on, that life was nothing but an awful song.
I'm 18 years old, I'm from Stanton, Virginia, and I'm a student. I decided to audition for American Idol just because it was kind of my dream. I followed it from season one and been enjoying the ride. It's a blast.
Woo! I'm going to Hollywood! Woo!
So I was sitting there with the rest of the top 50 on the final judgment show, and I have a wonderful technique of singing the Teletubbies theme song in my head whenever I feel nervous. And that's what I did for about 3 hours. And I was the last person to go up that elevator, me and Kyle. It was so difficult.
What, man? Colton, you're through tonight.
When they told me I made it through, it was complete and utter shock. It's amazing being in the top 24 and experiencing all of this. It's indescribable. This is my biggest dream. That's all I've ever wanted.
Caught in a trap, I can't walk out, because I love you too much, baby. Why can't you see what you're doing to me when you don't be?
You had a good time, and you were jumping at the end. I love that, man.
Yeah.
You were really feeling that, right? Do you love this song? Did you love this song?
I love that song.
It's a great song, man. It's a great song. Well, listen, you did a pretty good job on it, man, I think. It, you know, started a little rough for me, but by the end, you started feeling yourself and finding your way with it. So I thought it was actually all in all pretty good.
Thank you.
Yeah.
It was nice to see a different side of you, because we've heard the ballads. But it's nice. You were having fun out there. I don't feel it's your best performance, but I do think you gave it an eager and fun attempt. I really do.
Colton, it was okay. It wasn't quite as bad as the other Elvis song. But I tell you where I'm having a problem, okay, with what I just saw, is that the whole idea of this show is to find a recording artist. So what did I get from that performance? Nothing. It's just a young kid who might have a career in musical theatre, but you have no relevance in today's chart or in the music industry. It was just young kid singing an Elvis song quite well. I'm not looking at a recording artist or listening to a recording artist. And that is my issue. You didn't represent yourself tonight. It was just a complete waste of time.
Well, that's the key thing. Not tonight, but we've seen some good performances from you.
Can you help us, you know, America voting tonight, help us understand what you mean by looking for a recording artist? What's the difference in what he did and an actual recording artist's voice?
You look for something unique, special, most importantly, current.
But the theme is 60s. He's got to sing a 60s
song. As I said this before, Ryan, you can cover songs which are 40, 50 years old.
You can make it dope.
You can make them sound good.
Yeah. They could be on the radio.
That was very karaoke. As I said, the whole idea of the show is you've got to find a recording artist.
Well, hopefully, Colton, you'll have the chance to show more sides that makes it not a poor man's version of.
Okay, that's a lot clearer.
I'll stop it.
I just think if people spent more time worrying about their voices rather than their hair.
Oh my God.
That's called hopeless, that box cut you've got.
Yes. Hands for Ryan Seacrest, touche, Ryan Seacrest.
1-866-IDOL-09. 1-866-436-5709, or you can text the word vote to 5709. Thank you very much for enduring all that. Now, some say he looks like Peter Frampton or maybe Leif Garrett. You decide. We'll be back after the break with Garrett Haley. Welcome back to Idol. Just three left to go tonight. You're voting for your favorite, but not until the end of the show. I want to introduce you to Garrett Haley. And like Colton, Garrett hasn't had a lot of camera time in the audition shows, but somebody else was in the same situation and she ended up winning the competition. That was Kelly Clarkson.
Exactly.
So what should we know about you, Garrett?
I've been watching this show since I was like 9 or 10, and I too look like Ellen DeGeneres. Eh? No?
No. More like Leif Garrett. Do you know who Leif Garrett is?
Yeah.
You do?
I get that a lot from Peter Frampton.
Yeah? Yep. Girls screaming at you?
Yeah.
Yeah?
All the time. Yeah.
Well, it's good to be you then.
Oh, yeah.
You ready to hit the stage?
Yeah, let's do it.
Okay. Seems like you want to keep talking to them. Go ahead.
Okay. Anyways.
No, all right. Good luck. What's this?
An emerald from the mountains thrust towards the sky, never revealing their depth.
I'm 17 years old from Elida, Ohio, and I am a student. Well, me and my family were in San Diego on vacation, and I was like, Mom, I should try out for American Idol. My mom always told me to go big or go home. Confidence was an issue in Hollywood. I mean, like, I've never sang in front of this many people before.
Confidence is not there like it was when we first saw you, when you first auditioned. And you really wowed me when I first saw you.
Yeah, it's all right, though. I gotta work with what I got. For the final judgment.
There it goes.
Once the elevator doors open, I look down the hall and I see Paula and Randy smiling.
You're always like a positive guy. You got a smile on your face. Dude, the good news for you this time is this is a yes, dude. You're going on, dude. Be happy. Stay happy, baby.
Being here right now, just being a part of the top 24 is incredible. And this is opening so many doors for me and just giving me a lot of opportunity to show myself to the world.
Tell me that you're leaving. I can't believe it's true. There's just no living without you. Don't take your love away from me. Don't you leave my heart in misery. If you go, then I'll. They say that breaking up is hard to do. Now I know that it's true. Don't say that this is the end. Instead of breaking up, I wish that we were making up again.
That's over, right?
I'm glad. I'm happy.
Well, listen, I mean, you know, that's a great Neil Sedaka song. I mean, I love the song, but the thing that struck me with this performance here is you didn't do anything with it. It's like, don't be afraid to make these things your own, just because wherever the song's from, any song older than a song 6 months ago is old. Yeah. So you got to bring something new and interesting to it. So it okay. just, you had a couple little pitch problems, and it just wasn't really, it was just kind of boring.
All right.
It was.
So good. When you have songs like this, it's okay to get into Ricky Minor's ear and say, you know what, I'd like to split up the song. I'd like to start off slow, and then I'd like to grab a beat with it and change it up. Because if you stay at that slow tempo,
it
brings the performance down.
Okay.
Yeah. Don't be afraid to be courageous with that.
Take chances, baby.
Okay, I'll do that.
I think they've said it all. It was boring. Your voice sounded a bit whiny. You look terrified.
Oh, man.
And it looks as if you've been shut up in your bedroom.
What?
It looks like you've been shut up in your bedroom for about a month. You know, you look verging on haunted. You know, you're pale.
Oh,
and,
it's so, you know. You know what? Are you looking in
there? He wasn't all of that.
But you know what I mean?
He does not know.
You need some fresh air, and you need to make yourself young.
You're in Cali, yeah. I mean, I get
no, but you do. I mean, seriously, you need to make yourself.
Well, fresh air? What are you talking about?
I'm talking
you need
about.
To breathe.
You
are you breathing?
I'm breathing.
No.
Yeah, right.
Fine.
Exactly.
The problem is that once again, you're not making yourself relevant, young, current.
Yes, it was just chocolate.
Yeah. And go tanning.
It was just very...
Go tanning. Go tanning.
Spray tan, Ryan.
I don't mean that. Yeah. I don't mean that.
I think I understand what you're saying.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I think I do. Yeah. I mean, it's
more
a strange
V-neck,
way of saying it.
More V-neck, more
In heads. Other words, what I'm trying to say is you're a young girl. How old are you?
17.
Right, okay.
I'm worried
then you've
about
got
you.
To become relevant. To
I mean, I think he's chosen the wrong words, but the essence is...
The fact that you know what he means is scary.
It's scary. I
well, what do you think about what they're all saying?
You know, I'm going to take it as constructive criticism, work with it. You know, I'm going to listen to every single one of them, what they said, and learn from it.
It's a great attitude, my man.
You know?
Very, very good. Thank you.
Very good.
All right. So, the number, 1-866-IDOLS-10. 1-866-436-5710, or you can text the word VOTE to 5710. Good luck.
Thank you very much.
We're going to take a break, but we're coming back with our first contestant to play an instrument tonight, Jason Castro. Friends, would you like to walk around with one of the top 24 in your pocket? Well, you can by downloading their songs exclusively on iTunes. You could have Jason Castro whenever you'd like. He's up next. You ready?
Yeah.
All right, take a look at this.
Don't hear it now. We're going all the way.
I'm 20 years old. I'm from Rockwall, Texas. I grew up playing drums all my life. In Dallas, I was not 100% confident. I'd only sang in public about 5 times before that.
I think this guy's got something, and I like drummers.
Jason, you're going to Hollywood.
Welcome to Hollywood, Jason.
To get such great feedback was just, like, awesome. Yeah! Hollywood Week was really exciting. The first day really worked out for me, and the judges really liked it.
One of my favorite auditions today.
Yep.
Thank you.
That last day was... emotionally draining, just sitting and waiting, and it was just crazy, so I didn't know what to expect. You know, it was totally anyone's game.
Yes, 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 congratulations, so yes!
It's well done, good celebration.
My whole life I've always kind of stayed in the back and, you know, just shied away from everything. And so tonight is the biggest performance of my life, and I'm putting myself out there today and see what everybody thinks.
Day for a daydream. Oh, what a day for a daydreaming boy. And I'm lost in a daydream. Yeah. I'm dreaming about my bundle of joy. And even if time ain't really on my side, it's one of those days for taking a walk outside. Yeah. I've blown this day for a day in the sun. follow my face in someone's new mood long. I've been having a sweet dream. I've been dreaming since I woke up today. It's starring me and my sweet dreams. Cause she's the one that makes me feel this way. And you can be sure that if you're feeling alright, a daydream will last you long into the night. Tomorrow at breakfast you might prick up your ears. Or you may be daydreaming for a thousand years. What a day for a daydream. What a day for a day, a dreaming. Oh, oh, oh.
I like the little accent with the whole guitar vibe, but you strumming along and playing along with it. I love that. You tried to make some interesting things vocally with the melody and stuff. Little pitch problems there, especially on that little high note there at the end. It got away from you a little bit. It went a little sharp. But, you know, it was all right, man. It was all right. Didn't blow me away, but it was all right.
For me, you did blow me away. And you got me right back hooked into when I saw you the first time. And given the song choices, you picked a song that was really absolutely perfect for you. And your take on it, it was so minimal, effortless, and really joyful. And the expression, less is more, I really feel that you nailed that. And I already felt like you're a performer who's coming back and just getting up and playing something on his guitar. What color?
Green.
You know what? You are a blend of every favorite color that I know.
Jason, I thought that was in the top two performances of the night. And I'll tell you why. Because you, like David, have just got it. You're great with the camera, very good choice of song. Actually, I wouldn't have had the band join, funny enough. It would have worked better, just you and the guitar.
Yeah,
but you made it sound current. It proves my point. It doesn't matter how old the song is. It's what you do with it. And as Paula said, or I think you said this, it was effortless.
I did.
You have charisma. I thought it was terrific.
Yeah.
You have a look of awe, shock and awe.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, it's scary up here.
Is it? You're a little nervous?
Yeah, I was really nervous. I don't think I said anything to, like, the very end of all that.
But after that kind of feedback, it's got to give you confidence if you make it into the next round.
It feels good.
Yeah? All right. Well, if you want to vote for Jason, who's still in shock with all of it, 1-866-IDOLS-11. It's 1-866-436-5711. Or you can text the word vote to 5711. Well done. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Good job, man. We'll be right back with the final performance of the night from Michael Johns. Welcome back to Idol. One left. Have we saved the best for last? Let's find out. It's Michael Johns.
You were terrible.
I'm 29 years old. I'm from Australia originally and now living in Atlanta.
Dude, I was really impressed. You're very good audition. Oh,
thank you. I've been here 10 years. My whole adult life has been here in America. No, I love being here.
You're through, Michael.
Welcome to Hollywood, baby.
It can happen. That's all I'm saying, guys.
Each step, I mean, you're a little bit more in control of what your destiny can be. In my favorite part of Hollywood, hands down, was I sang Bohemian Rhapsody. I just kind of went through a little routine when I got on the stage. When I got my microphone, put it in the middle of the stage, you know, look down at the ground for a second and then I look up. That's the only thing I could have controlled in the whole audition. Mama.
Michael.
Yes, sir.
Best audition of the day.
Thank you. Hopefully people can just judge me on my voice and my passion and not about, like, whether I can say, g'day.
You know that I would be a liar.
to say to you, girl, we couldn't get much higher. Come on, baby, light my fire. Come on, baby, light my fire. Try to set the night on fire.
Yo, yo, what a way to end a great night, man. I tell you what, man, I love you. The day that I saw you, because, like, you just throw all caution to the wind. You're always you. You sing great. I always feel like I'm seeing, like, a true legend rock performer. You're like a Michael Hutchins. You don't care. There's no, like, you would have bombed tonight, baby. That was hot. I love that.
Excellent way to end the night, and you did set everyone up on fire. I mean, this was a great, great ending, really was. And you are a great part of the show.
Thanks, you, Paul. Glad to be here.
You really are.
I would say, Michael, you are the most consistent contestant we've had. Every one of your auditions I've loved. Yeah. I didn't like it as much as Bohemian Rhapsody, by the way, because I think you were over trying. But you have the natural charisma of a lead singer. You have just got it. No problem.
Michael, congrats, man. Before the show, you kind of said to me that you're worried about what Simon might think, thinking back to Hollywood Week, right?
Well, you know, when we chose these songs, I didn't know that they were going to show my first, because I sang Light My Fire for a little bit in Hollywood Week, so I wasn't sure, like, if Simon was going to go, okay, we've seen that, next.
Well, I'm sure you're happy with this outcome, then.
Yeah, thanks, guys.
Good job, man. If you want to vote for Michael, 1-866-IDOLS-12, 1-866-436-5712, or if you're with AT&T Wireless, you can text the word vote to 5712. Good luck to you, man. Thank you very
Thank
much.
You very
Appreciate
much.
It. We're going to open the lines soon. Remember, the two who poll the lowest number of votes are out on Thursday night. Kids, stop. Stop. So my point is, don't let your favorite disappear. Here are your numbers one more time.
I'm going to wait till the midnight hour. That's when my love begins to shine. You're the only girl I know. And I really love you so. In the midnight hour, I love you more today than yesterday. Woo! But not as much as tomorrow. I can see me loving nobody but you for all my life. When you're with me, baby, the skies open. There's such a lot of world to see. One is the loneliest number one. Is the loneliest number one. Is the loneliest number that you'll ever do. I'm just as sure how the wind's gonna blow now. The women come and the women gonna go now. Before you tell them. Told me.
suits my clothes. And we can't go on together. We're suspicious minds.
Suspicious minds.
And we can't build our dreams on suspicious minds.
And they say that breaking sweet dream. I've been dreaming since I woke up today. It's starring me and my sweet dreams, yeah. 'Cause she's the one that makes me feel this way.
Try to set the night on fire. Try to set the night.
There are the guys, 12 different choices, 12 different numbers. Let me go to the judges before we say goodnight. Randy, to sort of sum up what we saw here on stage.
Dude, it's a fierce competition, man. Season 7 was blazing hot tonight, Ryan. Man, these boys put it down. Woo, it's anybody's game right now, man. Strong.
Round of applause for the gentlemen. All right, that's almost it for tonight. Thank you to Randy Jackson, of course. Paul Abdul. And thanks to Ricky Miner and the band. But most of all, thank you for watching. Tomorrow, the girls will be taking the stage by storm, and here they are.
Christy Lee Cook. Amanda Overmeyer. Alexandria Lushington. Joanne Borgella. Brooke White. Saisha Mercado. Elena Whitaker. Asia Epperson. Amy Davis. Katie Malloy. Carly Smithson. And Rami Almaluba.
All right. Nigel, that reminds me of your show. It's time to get to work, America. The lines are open. They're going to stay open for at least 2 hours. Be patient. If you don't get through the first time, keep on trying. We'll be back with the ladies, 8, 7 Central, tomorrow night. Stay tuned for your local news. Good night, everybody. Good job.